Bugs. Here's a little shed cat, Aragrat. And it's been a few days since I posted any progress on my Scamp build, so I thought, regardless of whether I've got too much more done or not, I'll record where I'm up to for everybody. Here I am back in the shed. So, what I've got here at the moment is an awful big pile of offcuts. An awful lot of that's still going to be used too. Some planks on the floor. There's plank two sections on the floor there. And some deck pieces, other stuff you've seen. The hull bottom, you've seen that before too. And what I'm currently doing is putting the bevel on the planks and the other pieces. There's two bulkheads, bulkhead one and bulkhead eight transoms, that need to have their edges beveled. Hang on a sec. Adele, break it down a bit, darling. That's better. I normally have some classical music going while I'm out in the shed, but today I've had too much coffee, so I've got a bit of a dell. So there's a rolling bevel gets put onto the upper edges of planks one and two. And hopefully you can see there that this plank one is almost done. Look along the rolling bevel there for a minute. It's a little bit of a lump in there in the middle. I'm not going to get too religious about it because, after all, if it gets within 4 millimetres of where it needs to go, you can fill it with epoxy. Well, that's a theory anyhow. So here's some of the tools I'm using for this part of the job. A scribe, a square, an easy lap sharpener for quick sharpening things. A block plane. This is quite a cheap one. This was about 20 bucks. It's a little pressed steel body with a pretty okay blade, actually. And that's used to take out large volumes of wood fairly quickly. I've got a much smaller block plane that I use to follow up with. It's a Lee Nielsen. I'm not sure if you're allowed to advertise brands of things where I'm going to put this, but what the heck. And some sandpaper and a microplane. I've never used one of these before. It's sort of like a surfform tool, only it's a surgical version of it. It is sharp enough, you really, really don't want to slip with this and have the blade slip onto your flesh when you're putting a bit of pressure on it. I'm not supposed to put much pressure on anyhow, but it's a stainless steel, hardened stainless steel plate with pressed teeth into it. The teeth are sharpened to a wicked sharpness. So, you know, the process is measure out and draw the bevel on it, and then block plane it to within an inch or half a millimetre of its life, and then take a nice block plane, a Lee Nielsen, and get it down to within really a tenth of a millimetre or something, some really close amount. And you can see if you're basically following the smoothness of the plies in the wood, make sure that they're nice and evenly cut away. And as that comes to a blunter angle up the top, that's pretty well all there is. Anyhow, I've got four pieces of plank ones and four pieces of plank twos, and the transoms to do. So that's all I'm going to show you today. Next time, hopefully, I'll show you casting some lead. But today, this is what we're doing, and I'm having a lot of fun. I'm a bit compromised. I'm a bit conflicted here. I really, really want to get this boat on the water and sail it, but I'm having so much fun building it. I sort of need someone to turn up and say, hey, I've built a Scamp, come and sail with me a couple of days a week, and have the other 5 days to build your own. That ain't going to happen. Shame, but there you go. All right, this is Bruce in Largs, South Australia. That's as far as I've got with my Scamp build, Scamp number 179.